Hey, what's up? My name's Daniel McLaughlin, and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to show you a pedalboard build I did recently for a friend of mine named Chad. Chad is a former student of mine, and he's also a great guitar player. Chad also shares a mutual appreciation of John Mayer and his guitar playing. It's been fun talking to him about some of the certain aspects of John's playing, some of his signature gear that he uses. Chad's got a great collection of some of John Mayer's signature guitars. If you want to check it out, I'll put his Instagram right here. So we started talking about building a John Mayer board about a month before I actually got started. It was meant to complement his new two-rock amplifier. And I won't beat around the bush. I saw the opportunity with the gear that Chad already owned to build a killer John Mayer Continuum and John Mayer Trio-style tone pedal board. He already had a blues driver, and he had that classic Tube Screamer TS-808. The exotic BB preamp was just a cool pedal that Chad wanted included. And I also recommended the Klon KTR, just because I think it's the best representation of a Klon Centaur without being a Klon Centaur. That pedal is made by Bill Finnegan, and it just makes that board altogether much more versatile. The other two pedal necessities I saw were a Keeley Katana Boost and a Way Huge Aquapus. Those are two pedals that are consistent in John Mayer's pedal board builds. And then the Strymon Flint is just a great choice of reverb anytime. I saw it as the best summation of all of John Mayer's uses of reverbs. It also nails that Victoria reverberato vibe that John Mayer kind of secretly uses. You never really hear it. But it's great for that subtle tremolo that you hear on songs like Gravity. I want to have some fun with this video, so let's get some music going and we'll see the build. First of all, I always make sure to do a general inspection and cleaning before I start. Some contact cleaner in the jacks, and I always take off any rubber feet. Everything's been tested beforehand, and I get inside the pedal to remove the battery and tape off the connector if needed. By the way, I'm using a Voodoo Lab Pedal Power 2 Plus, a Pedal Train Junior, and Evidence Audio Monorail cable. I stand by this stuff 100%, and it's what I use on my own pedalboard. I also like to tape off my power cables and instrument cables with a bit of red gaffer's tape. Just helps discern your cable from house cable or someone else's cable. Also, a cable tie can be nice. And once I'm done prepping the board, I get a general sense of the pedal placement, and I like to start to lay down a little bit of the dual lock. Dual lock is expensive for a fastener, but it's so worth it. I don't really like using Velcro on my boards anymore. Once I have a good idea of the placement, I build out the patch cables. They're always cut to length, and on a build like this where there's no switcher, it's a monopath, and there's no volume pedal, it's fairly simple to get the patch cables in place and not need to worry about planning where the power cables go. And when it comes to the power cables, I try and get channels of power cables going to intersect with the patch cables in a perpendicular fashion to avoid added noise. Even though these Evidence audio cables are shielded really well and have a fairly low noise overall, I just try and keep it in mind. It also makes the cable management easier when installing the tie downs and zip ties. And after a bit of tidying up, it's done and it's ready to be tested.